new things in life more appealing than the idea of escaping the city, moving to an incredible lifestyle, and building an amazing home to take advantage of all your gifts. And today we're about to make the family who have done just that and created an amazing lifestyle business by sharing your home on Airbnb.
And then that just leaves us to look after our guests. It's been a really helpful financial approach. I'm sure we can see a good worker. I think they often feel like they're both. But yeah, it's beautiful. It's needed a lot of work to get it here now. It's got a lot of good lines, and anything that we've changed or taken away, we've tried to reutilize a little bit of it. Yeah, different setup to reuse the setup.
Looking at the way that the house is laid out, I can see why it would work so well as a family home as well. For sure.
Yeah, it's a cute little room, right? It has changed a lot from before, but pretty much. use that on the floor space and out, and also in here there were some strange shelves which we're now utilizing for a bit of space that's functional for them.
And it has got this room that is above us.
Yeah, that's right.
Really is something very special. This house bus is just so funky, so quirky, and yet really has description of this video.
Thank you. And I just locked the doors of the entrance way to your home. They set the mood and the tone for how you feel about your space. And so I really have grandiose atmosphere space. And so I decided to make this like an epic, and then it sort of influenced the rest of the feel, sort of the themes, the motifs of the house. So I got a little bit of country boy in me, a little bit of West Coast boy in me. So I tried to kind of incorporate both worlds to that back half of Liz's feel.
Absolutely. And maybe a little bit of Viking in you as well, because it definitely has that grandiose entrance way feel. It's like walking into a hole with a hollow or something.
Yeah. The Viking is your home.
And then that's the handle. Wow.
I think that's my favorite part of the door. To make it happen, you have to have something like that, you know? So,
wow, yeah.
So those are kind of a Roosevelt elf. Yeah, somebody gifted those to me, actually. So it was a privilege to get to receive them.
Beautiful. Well, the exterior of the home is absolutely enchanting, and I cannot wait to see what you've done inside. Can we take it out?
Oh, absolutely. That's yours.
All right. Is absolutely stunning.
Thank you.
Walking into this space, it has this incredible sense of openness, doesn't it?
It does. Yeah, I really wanted that to be more conceivable, that ancient design, you know, the visual views, and just that illusion of the sense of openness.
And the way that you have the boxes in here is both as well.
I love that. Yeah, kind of cavernous.
It certainly is. And this light feature, wow.
Thank you. I think, you know, I have everything I have in the world.
Absolutely. And this coffee table here is really neat. Can you tell me about this?
Yeah, so a friend of mine was going to help us in a barrel of gold, and he actually gifted that to me. So I think this is not an outdoor similar to something that we need to do. So I thought it would be fun to put it in the house. Remember what your tree were. Whatever you lack in the space, it's like you get to bear it. It's like, you know, it just reminds me of that a little bit. And it also comes to mind that you should be back down as well. So, especially for me, what a tree.
I love that. And you did take a look up his name in this one.
film is an amazing art form, and so I have those movie nights for sure.
Yeah.
Very cool.
And then considering the kind of vertical thing with the back on the wall,
this is actually one of the media areas where I come out, and that's my playground. This is where I work. So I thought, with a compass, maybe we'll have a chart that helps some people orientated.
Absolutely. And what a playground is this, huh?
It is. I'm beyond lost to be on the car, so.
Yeah. And then your kitchen. Look at that countertop.
Thank you. You know, the kitchen is special too for emotional reasons. A lot of the things in here came from my friends' properties. So Kevin and I actually nailed this countertop for me. And then another friend donated the gold fence. And that's what I made the cabinets out of. Everything in here is pretty much reclaimed. So it's a special feeling to have sort of the emotional component, the history of those friends, and the reused materials come together.
And so what Timba is this?
So this is done with fir. Yeah, this is grand fir. The panels on the doors are made of westernized cedar. And then the trimmer on the door is also fir. Most of the trimmer on the doors is an old base door that came out of the demo house. And they're all painted and built by the string steel trimmer and sanded down. And the wood is revealed to me again.
It certainly has. And it is beautifully paired with this diamond copper sanctum.
Thank you. I think that's one of my favorite parts of the house. It's the storage of the house for sure. It's pretty enough to be installed down in there, I think. So
I think you can.
Every house needs a second house.
Absolutely. I think you probably had a hard time getting in there, though.
I do. I haven't tried yet,
though. There's something about the combination of copper and hard timber that just immediately makes a space for us. Probably in the ultimate.
It's so true. There's something about the sort of elemental. And so those earthy sort of elements, I thought that that's where you need that.
And these light fittings are just stunning. These are actually made from the same thing that we use on the roof.
That's right. Yeah. I really wanted to bring the outside of the house inside, just to sort of have that continuity of theme. And again, kind of bring that element of the rusty thing. I feel like it sort of complements the red and the green and the yellows and the oranges and the woods and the fur. So we've got just to bring that into this side of the house.
Very nice. And you've got a flushing toilet in here.
Yeah, it's true. That's what we've been pumping and pumping. 15 years old. And I thought, that's so cool. How can I incorporate that?
just think, it's totally overwhelming at Concord. What was it that empowered you to push through and make this happen?
Luckily, what made it possible is I didn't understand the gravity of what I was jumping into.
Yeah.
But once you start, you realize that just like everything else in life, all you can do is one step in front of the other. And small bites at a time. And so I think the biggest factor is the real thing that we have to do this house. And now I know a lot. And I'm not a genius or an Einstein. I'm just a regular guy who is willing to try.
Matt, you have constructed such a beautiful home here. And while it might be a tiny house, I think this stands as a tremendous, huge monument to your determination in making this happen. Thank you so much for sharing everything.
Thank you, guys. Thank you for having me.
Yeah. lights for the round and the little strange with them outside.
Thank you.
It's been 1 year since we moved in.
The zoning is where it goes and the coding, and both of those two things have to match. They have to match.
So there's definitely interest here in the city of Ashland of using tiny houses in a couple of different ways, which is pretty exciting to see. And we're starting to see that in a lot of towns across the U.S. now. Seeing how tiny houses can go from being sort of this offbeat, unusual thing to a normal type of housing that benefits for both people living in it and for the cities in which we will be permitting those structures.
And then from there, look at land use, zoning, neighborhood acceptability, because some neighborhoods are not going to want
look at what the ordinances are and try to figure out why those ordinances are in place. In some cases, they may have passed a long time ago, and you may ask your building officials, so why is there a 1,000-square-foot minimum? And they may not know the answer to that. So they don't know the answer to that, then maybe there's the potential for you to have a conversation with them about potentially putting something in that's less than 1,000 square feet and show why that's a good idea. In some places, they may know